In relation to sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system innervation, there are two exceptions to the rule, its sweat glands and adrenal medulla. From physiology we know that usually sympathetic innervation consists of two parts. From thoracolumbar region of the spinal cord originates short preganglionic neuron that make a synapse with sympathetic ganglion, and to transmit signal preganglionic neuron secretes acetylcholine that acts on nicotinic acetylcholine receptor on ganglion, and from ganglion originates postganglionic neuron that make a synapse with target organ, and to transmit signal, as a rule, it uses norepinephrine that acts on norepinephrine receptor on target organ. In parasympathetic nervous system, basically the same principle. From nuclei in the brain or from sacral region of the spinal cord originates long preganglionic neuron that also uses acetylcholine that acts on nicotinic receptor on ganglia. And from ganglia originates short postganglionic neuron that uses acetylcholine that acts on muscarinic acetylcholine receptor on target organ. So the difference between sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system is that they originate from the different regions of central nervous system. Preganglionic neuron in sympathetic nervous system is short and in parasympathetic nervous system is long. Postganglionic neuron in sympathetic nervous system is long and in parasympathetic nervous system is short. But the main difference is that in sympathetic nervous system, postganglionic neuron uses norepinephrine that acts on norepinephrine receptor on a target organ. But in parasympathetic nervous system, postganglionic neuron uses acetylcholine that acts on muscarinic acetylcholine receptor on a target organ. But sweat glands are exceptions to the rule. Sweat glands are innervated by sympathetic nervous system, so from thoracolumbar region originates short preganglionic neuron that is connected to sympathetic ganglion and uses acetylcholine that acts on nicotinic acetylcholine receptor. And from ganglion originates postganglionic neuron that is connected to sweat glands. And the key feature is that postganglionic neuron uses acetylcholine that acts on muscarinic acetylcholine receptor on sweat glands and stimulates sweating. And this makes sweat glands an exception to the rule, because it's a unique case when sympathetic nervous system uses acetylcholine in postganglionic neuron, and also it's unique because organs that is innervated by sympathetic nervous system have muscarinic acetylcholine receptor. And it's a tricky concept because, for example, when blood pressure rapidly decreases, sympathetic nervous system become activated in order to keep blood pressure, and simultaneously patient experience diaphoresis, which is excessive sweating, because sweat glands are innervated by sympathetic nervous system. And in this case, what type of receptor on sweat glands is not so important because it's physiological response. But for example, muscarinic poisoning, muscarine acts on acetylcholine receptor and thereby it causes excessive stimulation of organs that are innervated by parasympathetic nervous system. And this manifests as bradycardia, meiosis, increased gastric acid secretion, etc. But also it causes excessive sweating. And in this case, it causes excessive sweating just because sweat glands have muscarinic receptor. And for example, atropine decreases sweat glands activity because it blocks acetylcholine receptor. So in case of medications, we keep in mind that sweat glands have muscarinic acetylcholine receptor because medications target particular receptor. So muscarinic agonist increase the activity, antagonist decrease the activity. In case of physiological mechanisms, we keep in mind that sweat glands are innervated by sympathetic nervous system, and activation of sympathetic nervous system causes sweating. And to remember this, recall that patients with cardiogenic shock experience sweating. They have low blood pressure, and to increase blood pressure, sympathetic nervous system become activated, and thereby sweat glands become activated. Another example is pheochromocytoma, with classical triad of symptoms as diaphoresis, headaches, and tachycardia. All of these symptoms are caused by excessive activity of sympathetic nervous system. So these two examples to remember that sweat glands are innervated by sympathetic nervous system. Another exception is adrenal medulla. Adrenal medulla also innervated by sympathetic nervous system. So from thoracolumbar region of the spinal cord originates preganglionic fiber. But in this case, preganglionic fiber directly innervate targeted organ. So preganglionic fiber secretes acetylcholine that acts on nicotinic acetylcholine receptor directly on adrenal medulla. It's explained by embryonic development of adrenal medulla because basically adrenal medulla on embryonic stage was a ganglion of sympathetic nervous system that was consists of postganglionic sympathetic neurons that have axons and dendrites. But through embryonic development, postganglionic sympathetic neurons lose their axons and dendrites and become chromaffin cells. And adrenal medulla consists of chromaffin cells that release norepinephrine and epinephrine directly to the blood. So in this case, there is no postganglionic neurons because adrenal medulla is postganglionic neuron itself.